Hey, what's up? This is Mitch the Klein, and this time a really short video about bouncing elements into audio in FL Studio. The reason why you want to bounce certain elements is because it lowers your CPU and you can close off synthesizers that you don't need anymore because you won't edit the sound anyway. So that way you can bounce it and then you can use it throughout your whole track as an audio file. So here's the intro of a track that I'm working on. But I want to fill it up with something interesting. And I made a plug right here. Make sure you mix it to mix a track. I added an EQ and a delay right here, and then it sounds like this. And personally, I like to fill my track with these kind of things. So this sounds pretty nice. And now I want to use this sound as an audio because I like how it sounds right now, and I don't want to edit it anymore. And by closing off the plugin that makes the sound Omnisphere, I can save a lot of CPU and I will get a better overview of the plugins that I have. So this is linked to the mix track, and inside the effect channel you can load up Edison, and then you can put this one on input so it will start recording once it gets a signal, or on play. In this case I will choose on play because the moment I start playing the song, it will record. Make sure to hit the record button and play the song. So when you stop playing the song, it will also stop recording. So now we have a recording from Edison. And if everything went well, you have a seamless loop. Sounds pretty fine. Sometimes you might get a kind of click sound. A solution for that is the declicking mode. And it will overlap the signals, as you can see. Another simple method is to loop the part that you want to bounce. So let's say I want to bounce the first 12 bars. Make sure you solo the sound that you want and then export. Press start and it will bounce this part of the track that you have. But because this is soloed, it will only bounce the plug sound. Then you have to search for the right folder where you saved it. And there is your bounce. The third method is the most easiest one. If you have FL Studio 20, there is the consolidation method. I think it wasn't available in FL Studio 12, so. Right click on the part that you want to bounce, consolidate this track from track start, and it will open up the export settings. press start, and then it will automatically place the render below the pattern that you wanted to export, or in this case above. And now you have the audio in your project, and you can close the synthesizer that you used to create the sound, because if you don't want to edit the sound anymore, then you don't use it, and it will save you a lot of CPU in the end. Thanks for watching, hope it was helpful, and see you in the next video.